Okay, in this video we're gonna make a laser pointer, quite a powerful laser pointer at that. It will be around 1.5 watts, blue color, and I'm gonna take you through the whole process from start to finish. So at first let's gather the components we're gonna use. This is a flashlight host, which we will put the laser in. You can see it's empty, there's no light bulb or something in there anyway. Just remove these things, we won't need it. And then we have this, which is This is a driver pill, which will host the driver, the current supply of the laser. It will go inside here, and this little brass ring here will keep the driver in place. Let's just get it out here. There we go. And then we have the laser diode. This is a, you can see it's kind of dirty and messed up because it's used, but it still works. And this is a 9mm diode, capable of going quite higher in power than we're gonna use. You can probably get up to 3 watts out of this thing, but we're gonna only drive it at around 1.4 amps, which will give around 1.5 watts of light. And then we have the actual driver, which we will build from components. It's a linear driver. It's based on this IC, which is a voltage regulator, and basically the laser needs a current regulator, but we can build a current regulator out of a voltage regulator by just fixing the voltage over a set resistance, and then Ohm's law will give us a current. So we need that resistor. We're going to use two 1.8 ohm resistors in parallel, and then the driver has some capacitors which will just smooth out any ripple and any noise and any well, not all the noise, but any overshoot and rush current when we power up the driver, because laser diodes are quite sensitive. They need a set current and not anything above that, or any spikes or anything, then it will break, basically. The last part of the driver, it's not in there, is here it is, the PCB, of course. So let's just get this tab off. All right. Yeah, there's one more part, which is where is it? It is the heatsink, because this needs a bit of a heatsink, otherwise it will just overheat right away. So where did I put the heatsink? Oh, it's in here somewhere, I think. Yes, here it is. We will use this thing as a heatsink. So this is built with this host in mind, and laser diode modules like this is 12 millimeter in diameter, this module that the diode is sitting in. So the diode would just slide in there, and then this thing will go in here, and then it will be connected to the driver, and then it will work, hopefully. So let's start with the driver. Let's just clean this off with some PenFlux here, and some of these components too, to make it easier to stick. I will just solder this for hand, but probably better to use some solder paste or something in a heat gun, but I'm used to this method, so I'll just solder them by hand like this. This very bad soldering iron doesn't even have temperature regulation, but it will do. Let's just use this plier here to hold our capacitor. We'll start with this. Just get a little solder on there and then reflow it. There we go. Let's just make sure this sits down correctly. Yes. Some more solder. Another capacitor. Some more solder there. Alright. Here we go. That's good enough. It's actually good if the solder reaches further out, because it will need to make contact with this ring here, because the ring will conduct the ground plane, and the ground plane needs to connect here and also some other places, but it's no problem if it spills a little over here. Let's do the resistors next. Just add a little bump of solder here to make it easier to connect. Okay. Here we go. Just push it down while I reflow this solder here. Whoops. That's not good. Let's try again. Here we go. Yup. Alright. That's fine. Okay. Let's do the other sides here. There we go. There we go. That should be fine. And then the voltage regulator, like this. I'll just add another puddle of solder here. Just melt this into place. Yep, that should be fine. Yep. And then these pins here need to be connected. Alright. Yep, that's good. Then we'll just add some leads up here to make it easier to connect the diode and such. By the way, before we do that, let's just mount this diode into the heatsink, because the heatsink paste can have time to dry before we need to move it anything. Let's just clean off this old paste here. Doesn't have to be perfect. Yeah, whatever. Let's get some new paste here. Alright, this has not dried up, thankfully. I used to have a problem with these, they just dry up after a while after you open them. And that's to be expected, I suppose. Anyways, let's just add some here. Alright. Yeah, whatever. That's fine. Just remove this screw here. Where is my iron? Let's just use this thing. Do I have a flat? I need to organize this. It's really messy right now. Maybe this will work. Is this too big? Yeah, I think it's too big. Yep. There we go. This is drying before it gets time to sit in the heatsink here. Alright. There we go. Let's close this up real tight, as tight as possible. The tighter the better, because it will transmit the heat away from the diode better, of course. So let's close this up so it doesn't dry. And then let's clean away some of this thermal paste. Let's just use my fingers here. I get a little dirty, but it doesn't matter. All right. That's fine. Whatever. Yep, it was the leads from this we were gonna do next. I have some wire here that I'll just use. Need to find the good wires. Here we go. This will be fine. Need to be about maybe this long. Strip the ends. There we go. Let's use this thing to make it easier. Okay. So like I said, this thing needs to make contact with this ring here, which will go on the outside. So I'll just leave a little bit of room there. Actually, it doesn't matter because I'll just solder it afterwards, but it's pointing out a little bit, and that's fine. There we go. That's okay. Should maybe sandpaper away these little tabs here. Let's see if I have some sandpaper in here. Okay. Hopefully this doesn't create too much static electricity. Laser diodes are actually quite sensitive to static electricity, so we need to be careful not to fry the diode. This is, for example, why it's stored with these two LEDs soldered together, so it doesn't get any static electric shocks in storage. Alright. Let's solder this on. Can you see this? Yes. All right. That's not very clean, but okay. Whatever, it should be fine. So, a little history on this driver here. You can see it says Moogassen. That's kind of funny. It's the name of a store run by a guy that's kind of famous in the laser pointer community. He kind of makes a store, and then he runs it for like half a year or something, and then he got tired and then burnt out and then closed down the store. And then later he opened it again and then closed it down again. But he had very cheap parts, for example this driver. So it's a bit of a laser pointer history there. So let's install this thing in this ring here. Let's just press it down. Yes, that's good. Let's just solder this so we have a good connection here with the ground that I talked about. There's way too much solder on this thing. Not so easy. There we go. That should be fine. That should be good. Alright. Now, so one last thing we can do here. We can just add a little bump here for the battery connection, because alright. Because you can see the batteries here. There they are. It's flush, you know, so we need a little bump there, otherwise it can't make contact with this positive terminal. Alright, so this driver should now give out around 1.4 amps when I connect two lithium cells here. So this here is the positive and this here is the negative around here, and this will be installed kind of like this inside this pill here, so the negative current voltage will be transmitted through this housing here. As you can see, it is aluminium, and into the driver like this, and then the positive will just go directly from the batteries. So let's install it in this thing. Actually, it's best if we use some heat sinks. Well, not heat sinks, but some heat, well, you see what I mean. This thing is like a heat spreading pad. I don't know what it's called, but we will put some up on there so it will make contact here, and this whole pill will act as like a heat sink for this driver, because the driver will output quite a lot of heat too. Not just the diode. Here we go. I can layer it in two like this. It should be enough. Maybe three would be better. No, it's probably fine. Doesn't need to be so good, but it's just better than nothing. Have a little bit of heat sinking on this driver. Okay, like this, and like this. Just put this like that. Okay. Alright. Let's press it in. There we go. And that's the finished power supply, whoops, in the pill. This will screw in like this. So now this part is actually done. So the batteries can just go in here. but we won't do this just yet. And we can just connect now this to the diode. Let's clean this up before I forget. So this will go in here, and then this will screw on like this, but these lead wires are a bit too long, so let's just trim them down a little bit. So here, now that we destroy this connection here, we need to be careful not to touch these terminals at the same time, because then we risk destroying the laser diode from electrostatic shock. So let's trim these two here. And let's just unscrew this while I connect these two things, because it will be simpler. Yeah, actually we're gonna need some heat shrink to insulate, I think that's the right word. Yeah, isolate, insulate, that's the same word in my native language, so I'm not sure what's the correct one in English, but some here's a bunch of heat shrink tubing. We can probably use this. It's probably enough. And then one more. Yep. Add this like this, then like this, and then we can solder. Oop, I almost forgot, this needs to be in like this before. Okay, the positive terminal. Not very clean there. Let's just take this, put it together a little bit. There we go. Whatever, doesn't need to be perfect. Here we go. Get more. There we go. That should be fine. So now we need to shrink this heat shrink. Do I have my lighter here somewhere? No? Okay. Use this heat gun here. I'll just wait until I've finished both of them, actually. Okay. Here we go. Should be fine. Oops. Cover this one and cover this one. All right. Now let's use this. It's a bad idea. Should have had my lighter here, so it would be much easier, but I can't find it. There we go, that should be fine. So now it's almost finished actually. We can just put these things together. Let's do this first. And then let's do this thing. Need to be careful not to twist the wires here too much or they will just break. Okay, and then this final thing, oops, O-ring is falling out. There we go. Just hold this down so it doesn't rotate and twist the wires inside. Okay, that should be fine. One last thing, this lens here won't do, this is no good. By the way, here you can see the laser diode inside the module. But this laser lens here is acrylic. This is acrylic inside and that's no good. It will just melt from the laser light because it's so powerful. So we need to find a different lens, which I have here. Yes. This is a glass lens. Yep. This is an anti-reflective coated 3-element glass lens, so this will actually do quite well. It won't be the most efficient lens possible, but it will have a relatively clean dot and beam because it filters out some of the noise around the core of the dot. But we also need some kind of knob around the lens to hold it in place, and I got that here, so let's just put this on first. So these lenses are all acrylic, you can see from all the lasers I've built, and I just throw them away because they're no good. Well, I don't throw them away, I just put them in there, but same thing, they won't get used ever, I think. Here we go. This should be finished, actually. So I guess it's the moment of truth. Will this work? Let's load the batteries here. These are lithium cells, so 3.7 volts. Two of them. All right. All right. Oh yeah, there we go. Guessing by screwing this thing. That is a working laser. So, how powerful is this? Well, let's test it. This is a laser power meter. You can see Hyperion. It's one of the budget models out there, but it's quite good. So all we need to do is point here on this sensor, which is just an, I think it's like one of those cooling modules, but it's used to detect the current changes when one of the sides heated up from the laser, and then just convert that into power. But I don't know the details. Let's check it. Oh yes. Oh, it's a bit more powerful than I thought. And this is very good. Around 1700 milliwatts. 1.7 watts, that is. It's quite a nice laser, this. So if you ask me if it can burn stuff, then yes, it absolutely can, but I'm not sure I want to do this. It creates too much smoke, as you can see. I'll just stop that. But yeah, there you have it. How to build a laser from scratch. And of course, if you want to try this at home, you have to be careful. These things are not toys. Basically, don't ever point it towards other people or cars or helicopters or whatever, and use protective gear such as safety glasses. Basically, kind of treat it like a weapon, because it kind of is. But there you have it. Thanks and see you later.